I want to take a little time out to explain something that I think is extremely important for women to understand. I'm referencing a lot of the comments that I was reading under the March 2017 video I did entitled Ghosting, Why Men Ghost and What It Means When They Try to Come Back. And it was very interesting to me, you know, because there's so many videos, I really lose track of, I just don't really have the time to go and check each one and keep up with all the comments and everything. But this time I did, and I was just shocked at what I saw. There are women and men who honestly do not get why somebody would ghost them. I don't know whether to think this is a severe case of narcissism where they think they're too good to get ghosted, or if they really and truly believe that they are entitled to someone coming along who can't, obviously doesn't want anything else to do with them. They are entitled to an explanation. And it's just amazing to me that you would really think that. So I'm going to go through this and I'm going to respond to some of these comments that I saw up on the wall. Okay, so now one guy, he says, you know, those who ghost and glorify ghosting, ghosting is basically an irresponsible and cowardly act. It's like stabbing a knife into someone while they are not watching simply because you think they have wronged you or you feel like discarding them. Okay, let's stop there. If you feel simply because you feel they've wronged you, that is a damn good reason, sir. If you feel like someone has wronged you, they violated your boundaries, they've done something to you, said something to you that is abusive and hurtful, you owe them nothing. Okay? You might want it. You want an explanation. But you know what really is going on when people say that they want to call these people names and all of this because they're hurt. They're hurt that they got rejected. But you know, that's part of life. You're not going to get every job you want. You're not going to get every woman you want, dudes. Girls, you're not going to get every dude you like. He's not going to stay with you. No matter if you have a kid, you buy a house with him, you buy a dog with him, he's not obligated to stay with you, even if you're married. That indicates more of a commitment and more likelihood. But does that tie someone to you for life? No, it does not. So you're likely to get rejected, dumped, whatever, at any time for any reason. What have I been telling you on this channel? To keep control of your emotions. You should never, in a situation where you are just dating somebody, just got to know them well, and this and that, you're not married to them. What are you investing all of these emotions for? In a lot of the instances, you as you read through these comments, you'll see that the people didn't really have a much of an established relationship. They were just dating, kicking it, whatever. Okay, so then this guy goes on and he says, you know, it hurts others. And if you feel good, you're sick to the core, unless you learn good and sincere communication skills, which is a better option than ghosting, you can never develop good, healthy relationship, romantic or otherwise, because you are so used to burning bridges instead of repairing them. Okay, you know, the bridge that leads to you, it's got holes in it, it's rickety, it's raggedy. Don't nobody want to walk on that shaky stuff. So because you think that somebody is obligated to repair something because you want them to, that's not how dating works. For either one of you can reject the other at any time for any reason. Okay, you might say something funky. I have dumped dudes because they said something I didn't like. Okay, they talked about my work. They put something down that is important to me. They made a crack about my daughter that I didn't like. Anytime for any reason. And I don't care how long I've been with you. I'm a ghost you because of the fact that you just violated a boundary. And I don't owe you no explanation to tell you in great detail what you did and how it made me feel and all this old stuff. I don't feel like exerting all that kind of energy on you. I've already decided that you're dusty and stupid and I don't want to be bothered. So why should I have to talk to you if I don't want to? See, this is about the person who's doing the ghosting. The people who got ghosted are all up in their feelings about it, as you see from these slides going by. They're all up in their feelings about it. But in reality, nobody owes you an explanation for why they don't want you no more. What you gonna do? See, this is the part that drives me crazy. Okay, so you're with this one person, right? this one person tells you, well, I don't like this and that about you, and you are like shocked. Okay, so what are you going to do now? Bend and change because that person said that they don't like it? Is that who you are or not? If that's who you are, then you just say, oh, okay, well, that was, you know, that's too bad, but it was nice meeting you, nice kicking with you, nice whatever, being married to you, whatever the issue is. But now, it's time for us to go our merry ways, deuces. That's how you handle yourself like a G, like a woman with some confidence and self-esteem. This kind of stuff that I'm seeing here, this is low self-esteem groveling. You want somebody to make you feel like you're okay, like you're good enough. There's nothing wrong with you, and that's why, you know, that you feel like there's something wrong with you, and that's why they left you. No, sometimes it's just that it's nothing wrong with you. They just don't want you no more. They met somebody they like better. Something you did turned them off. It doesn't mean you're a bad person. It just means that for whatever reason, in this time, in this day, you two ain't going, it's not working. Okay, and they don't want to go through a whole explanation about it, because I done told y'all. See, they get in your feelings. This is what you do. Somebody says, I want to break up. Why? What's wrong? What did I do? Okay, now they got to go through this whole long-winded explanation to tell you what they did. And you're going to be like, no, that's not how it is. You're misunderstanding. Give me another chance. This and that. Okay, now it's like this whole big deal. And they don't want to deal with that, especially if they know you, that emotional, low self-esteem kind of person is going to be groveling and acting all thirsty and desperate. They don't want to be bothered with that. It's the same thing in reverse with men. I told you what the dude I was living with, I'm trying to leave his behind. He up there hanging on my leg like in the cartoons. I was so disgusted. I was just so through with him. In that moment, I would have preferred that he stand up like a G, give me a hug and say, well, babe, it's been really nice. And yeah, I wish you the best. Something like that. I could have had good memories of him in that relationship. But instead, he's down on the ground. He's hanging on my ankle like I'm pulling to go to the door and he's trying to drag me back in the apartment. Oh my God, it was so terrible. That's why y'all get ghosted. Because if you represent yourself as that emotional, clingy, needy, thirsty, desperate, insecure type of individual, and they've seen examples of that all through their relationship with you, they're going to ghost you because they don't want to be bothered with your emotional outbursts and the begging and the whining and the crying and all the explanation and the phone calls you're going to be doing and the texting begging for another chance. They don't want to be bothered. Okay, they don't want you anymore. Stop doing that kind of stuff. And this main thing here is people need to be, you're sitting there and you're trying to make all these like character assassinations on the person. But, you're evil and you have no feelings and you're like from Satan. You're a child of Satan and you're heartless and it's cheap behavior and it's just gross and it's disgusting and all these negative things. You're not a worthy person. There's something wrong with you. You're a narcissist. All these lugs you're throwing at somebody. And this one girl says, it's called narcissistic discard. No, it's not. No, it's not. I mean, there is that. That is definitely a reality. But there's going to be a difference because you're going to know a narc now, right? You had a lot of education on this channel about what a narcissist is and how to identify one. So just because someone leaves you and doesn't want to talk to you anymore does not mean that they're a narcissist. It sincerely means that they've just had enough. Okay, they've had enough. It could be a very simple thing that you did, like I said, did or said something. You might think it's funny. Like a lot of these joke dudes, they make these little negs at women and think that stuff is funny and tell you if you get upset, you're just too sensitive. You're this and that. That kind of stuff with me will get you ghosted. You got one time. And I'm not going to tell you that what you said got on my nerves. I'm not going to tell you that you're stupid. I'm not going to say nothing to you because anything that I do after I decide that you're stupid and out of my life, that means I'm throwing good energy after bad. That means I'm still involved emotionally and mentally with you. And me telling you what's wrong with you means I'm investing in your betterment. I don't give a damn about you. Okay, I don't care whether you're good for the next person or not. I don't care if you have flaws. I don't care anything about you as long as you get out of my face. That's all I care about. That's the part you guys just don't seem to want to understand. When a person ghosts you, that means that, it's not going to work out. And it means they don't want to be bothered with you anymore. That's what it means. So here's some people talking about, well, you know, that person deserves closure. Why are you looking for somebody who does not want you, who doesn't want anything to do with you, for closure for yourself? There's a video on this channel about closure. I'll try to remember to link to it up above here. You give closure to yourself. No, you can't go to the person who is looking to escape from you for closure for your emotional state. That makes no sense at all. That is just like going the sheep going to the wolf saying, oh, Mr. Wolf, can you give me some closure? Do you see how much sense that makes? All you're going to do is get eat up again. You're going to get gnawed on some more. Okay, that makes zero sense. You close any and all doors to your heart, to your mind, to your home, to your life, yourself. You don't look for some man to do that for you. What are you guys thinking? And who thought up this stupid term closure anyway? It sounds like something off of some dumb soap opera. That doesn't exist. You just decided you're through with somebody and then that's it. You know, and saying that, you know, people is cowardly and it's crap and it's immature and it's, you know, you should communicate on an adult level and all this kind of stuff. All these little negative digs that you putting on a person who doesn't want you so you can feel better about getting rejected. That's all that is. You think I'm born yesterday and I don't know that? You guys, come on now. This kind of stuff here is ridiculous. It's not a selfish, cowardly thing to do. Well, it might be a little selfish, but because they definitely are more concerned with their feelings than they are yours. But, you know, when people ghost you, there's always a reason. There's a reason. You might not want to accept it, but it could be something as simple as he wanted to get some boontang and you said no. So he moved on to the next broad who was more willing and receptive. You know, I'm not saying you had to do it, but I'm telling you that's the reason why he did it. So accept it. Don't get your ego involved in it. You didn't want to sleep with him. Okay, you should be happy he left. No drama. Instead, you, oh, my ego, you know, I don't know what. He just dumped me. He didn't even try. This and that. What do you want? If you wanted to sleep with him, you should have said yes. If you didn't, then you said no, then that means you shouldn't care where he goes and what he does. It means you were just trying to play a game. If you want to sleep with the man, do it. If you don't want to sleep with the man, then don't. But don't get upset at him for going on down the road to find somebody who's going to meet the needs that he has, his desires, his wants, whatever. Okay, that's not for you to get mad about. The same thing in reverse. You know, I mean, guys will have things that they say, you know, a woman will say some really jacked up stuff to him. And then, you know, he doesn't like it. And so he can leave and he can say jacked up stuff to you. And then you can leave him too. Violating your boundaries, touching you inappropriately, taking your stuff, doing anything that you don't like. You have the right to, you know, just move on and just close his access to you. You don't owe him an explanation. You know, ghosting shows no character, they say. It's a narcissistic retaliation, she says. It's a retaliation to something you've done. It's an inability to think of anything but their own emotional discomfort at looking like a bad person. It's selfish and cowardly and out of a difficult conversation that they'd rather not have. It's sticking their heads in the sand to avoid the hassle of knowing that they've done something wrong and hurt someone. They don't have done anything wrong. I don't understand why you think it's sticking their head in the sand. Their head is completely out of the sand and they're looking at you and they don't like what they see. Okay? But you want to flip it around and try to make it seem like it's something, you know, really bad with them. And it's not the inability to do anything. You know, they don't care about you. They're on about their business. So, you know, all these emotions that y'all be having about somebody who doesn't want to be with you is just really kind of shocking. I don't know. But this guy, I hope you're reading all of these. You know, feel free to stop the video at any time and read the slides if they're going by a little bit too fast. But, you know, I liked what this guy had to say at the very end. That, you know, it's a golden rule to live by. He says, always go where your presence is celebrated and not tolerated. Unless you're involved in a serious relationship, the person don't owe you anything. Just move on and understand that every relationship, every friendship has an expiration date. And I think that's, you know, that's the most important thing. I think what's missing is the understanding that the person who is doing the ghosting is doing what they think is the best thing to take care of themselves emotionally. It doesn't have anything to do with you. You know, that's why I said, you know, it's kind of a narc response on the women's side, thinking that that this guy is ghosting because of something about them. It's nothing about you. It's the person just wants something else, and they don't want to deal with your emotional response, which, as you see by the responses, what they, the comments that they posted, it's exactly what the guy would have got. That's why he ghosted them. He don't want to be bothered with all of that. I mean, just reading what they wrote on the comments is like full of emotion and angst and all this drama and stuff. You think a guy's going to want to deal with a woman in that mental, emotional state face to face or on the phone? No, that's what I'm saying. If you a calm type of woman who, you know, just rolls with the punches and stuff, you're less likely to get ghosted because they feel all right with saying, well, you know, I don't think this is working for me. And you'd be like, okay, that's fine. And if they know you to be that type of chick, they're not going to be stressing about ghosting you because they know you're just going to accept it and it's going to be deuces out and it, everybody's going to be cool. But if you're the kind of woman who flies off the handle and gets all in your feelings about every damn thing, well, you can expect to get ghosted quite a bit because nobody's going to deal with your temper tantrums and your emotional outbursts and your just wig flipping out and stuff. Nobody's going to want to deal with all of that. We're adults here. You talking about this adult's responsibility for him to tell you he wants. It's yours also to handle it like an adult woman. And if a guy doesn't want you, don't ask him no questions like why and all this old stuff and crying and leaning on him and dragging on him and snotting all over him and all that old stuff. G up. That's ridiculous. It just is just a bad look. Have more pride about yourself. If somebody don't want you, let them go. Okay? Hold your head up. Let them go. And be all right with that, because if they felt like you weren't right for them for any reason, that means they weren't. Okay? They weren't. They were not right for you. Accept it and just let it go. This is Deb Cooper from SurvivingDating.com and here on the Debsterism channel. I hope you enjoyed it. If you're not a subscriber to the channel, please hit that subscription button and the instant notification bell. And I will talk to you real soon.